As a kind reminder, we ask that you turn your cell phones to silent. Good morning, and welcome to the Cathedral of Our Lady of Victory as we celebrate the 20th Sunday in Ordinary Time. The processional hymn is number 311, All the Earth, number 311.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. As we gather together in this cathedral and are joined by those who are watching by means of television and the internet, let us all now pause for a moment and to recollect ourselves in order to prepare ourselves, acknowledge our sins, and to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, for my fault. For my fault, for my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary of the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Oh,
Let us pray. O God, who have prepared for those who love you good things which no eye can see, fill our hearts, we pray, with the warmth of your love, so that, loving you in all things and above all things, we may attain your promises which surpass every human desire. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, observe what is right, do what is just, for my salvation is about to come, my justice about to be revealed. The foreigners who join themselves to the Lord, ministering to him, loving the name of the Lord, and becoming his servants, all who keep the Sabbath free from profanation and hold to my covenant, them I will bring to my holy mountain and make joyful in my house of prayer. Their burnt offerings and sacrifices will be acceptable on my altar, for my house shall be called a house of prayer for all peoples. The word of the Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, I am speaking to you Gentiles. Inasmuch as I am the apostle to the Gentiles, I glory in my ministry in order to make my race jealous and thus save some of them. For if their rejection is the reconciliation of the world, what will their acceptance be but life from the dead? For the gifts and the call of God are irrevocable. Just as you once disobeyed God, but have now received mercy because of their disbelief, so they have now disobeyed, in order that by virtue of the mercy shown to you, they too may now receive mercy. For God delivered all to disobedience, that he might have mercy upon all. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with
your A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. At that time, Jesus withdrew to the region of Tyre and Sidon, and behold, a Canaanite woman of that district came and called out, "Have pity on me, Lord, son of David. My daughter is tormented by a demon." But Jesus did not say a word in answer to her. Jesus' disciples came and asked him, "Send her away, for she keeps calling out after us." He said in reply, "I was sent only to the lost sheep of the house of Israel." But the woman came and did Jesus homage, saying, "Lord, help me." He said in reply, "It is not right to take the food of the children and throw it to the dogs." She said, "Please, Lord, for even the dogs eat the scraps that fall from the table of their masters." Then Jesus said to her in reply, "O woman, great is your faith. Let it be done for you as you wish." And the woman's daughter was healed from that hour. The Gospel of the Lord. One of the most significant changes in God's relationship with man that occurred in Jesus Christ is the offering of salvation to the whole world. The one cultural group with a special covenant with God would now be expanded to include every people in every land. Through the life, the suffering, the death, the resurrection, and the ascension of Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God, he takes away the sins of the world. Because of this inclusion, Jesus' church that he established, his people gathered together, have this quality about them. They are from all over the world. Jesus' church is universal. In fact, this is where we get the word Catholic from. It means universal. This is one of the four marks of the church. The church is one. She is holy. She is Catholic. She is apostolic. One of the things that I truly love about our parish, Our Lady of Victory, is its diversity. We have people of different races and cultures. We even have people who come from different parts of the world. We have people who own large businesses, and we have people who are very poor. We have old people, we have young people, families, we have the widowed, we have single people. We have city folks and cowboys. We have the healthy and the sick. We have the highly educated, and we have those who earn their living by the sweat of their brow. The list of all of our differences could go on and on, but there is something. There is something that unites us all, something that brings us all together here week after week, where our differences then tend to fade into the background as we sit right next to each other as brother and sister. What is this something that unites us all? This something is our common acknowledgement that we need a Savior because we are sinners. We are not a select group of people who think we are perfect or better than others. No, we are a people, regardless of where we come from, regardless of our situation in life, we are a people that know that the human condition, at all times and in all places, requires supernatural help, requires someone greater than us, requires someone greater than the best of us, requires the God who became one of us. This is why our focus when we gather together here week after week for Mass is not primarily on us, but is upon the one sacrifice of Calvary. Our focus is upon Jesus Christ and his offering, his sacrifice for the whole world. And our focus, our gaze on Jesus and his sacrifice unites all of us. Unites our prayers and unites the people to God. And not just the prayers and people of this parish, but the prayers and the people of every parish. The prayers and people directed and placed upon the altar all throughout the world, at all times, in every place. Part of the great beauty of the faith that we've received, part of the great beauty of the Catholic Church, is that being a Catholic means being connected to others even beyond these walls. Being a Catholic means being part of the universal church, the church throughout the world, the church militant, which includes all of us throughout the world still striving here on earth. It includes the church suffering in purgatory, and the church triumphant in heaven. all those saints and angels who are rejoicing as they see God face to face. Truly, our union with Jesus and his sacrifice, our union with his church, this Catholic, this universal church, and the forgiveness of sins that he freely gives to us, certainly all this is greater than anything that could ever divide us. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. And rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. With hearts and minds turned to the Lord, let us now offer to him our prayers and petitions.
For our Holy Catholic Church, may she be a light to the nations by showing the reality of God's truth and love, we pray to the Lord. For all nations, may they live in unity and peace, learning to work together for the good of all. We pray to the Lord. For children returning to school, for their teachers and administrators, may they each begin this year with the determination to do God's will. We pray to the Lord. For migrants and refugees, for all who are perceived to be different, may the barriers of judgment among us be broken down. We pray to the Lord. For all who suffer from chronic illness and those who endure diseases that are rare or difficult to treat, may God send his healing grace and compassionate caregivers. We pray to the Lord. For all the faithful departed, and for the repose of the soul of August Termas and the living and deceased members of the Shulock and Welfel families, for whom we offer this Mass, we pray to the Lord. For the needs listed in our parish intention book, and for those we hold in the silence of our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Merciful Father, graciously hear these our prayers and grant them according to your divine will, through Christ our Lord.
The hymn for the presentation of gifts is number 333. There's a wideness in God's mercy. Number 333.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive our oblation, O Lord, by which is brought about a glorious exchange, that by offering what you have given, we may merit to receive your very self, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you laid the foundations of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed man in your own image and set humanity over the whole world in all its wonder, to rule in your name over all you have made and forever praise you in your mighty works through Christ our Lord. And so with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim. To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world. Together with your servant, Francis, our Pope, and Brendan, our Bishop, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants. And all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you, for them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, where they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers in all things, we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation, and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect, make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying,
Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord. We profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts that you have given us this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who, through this participation at the altar, receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, who those sinners, hope in your abundant mercy, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen, amen, amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my room, but I say words of salvation. Thank you.
The communion hymn is number 200, Draw Near, number 200.
Oh,
Let us pray. Made partakers of Christ through these sacraments, we humbly implore your mercy, Lord, that conformed to his image on earth, we may merit also to be his co-heirs in heaven, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
I mentioned in my homily about being Catholic means being part of the universal, the worldwide church. It goes beyond the walls of this parish. Certainly it also means being belonging to the local church, which is the Diocese of Victoria. And this weekend in your bulletin, you'll notice an insert talking about the diocesan service appeal. This is basically how we fund the diocese, all of the diocesan-wide programs and everything, the functions, the operation of the diocese is through the diocesan service appeal. And each parish throughout the diocese is given a goal in order to support the diocese financially. And parishioners are asked to make their offering directly to this appeal to fund our local church and to support our bishop. And so I certainly want to thank all of those who have already contributed to this year's appeal and ask that everyone consider, if you haven't already, making a contribution. If we do not meet our goal, if the parish does not meet our goal, then we have to take those funds out of our operating account, and it restricts us here at the parish. And so again, more information is there in the inserts in your bulletin. I encourage you to please look at that this week. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Hymn is number 243, I Want to Walk as a Child of the Light, number 243.